Hello all, today we are going to see one carbon metabolism. So before going in the detail of one carbon metabolism, please subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. So one carbon metabolism. So groups which contain one carbon atoms are called as a one carbon group, and this one carbon groups are synthesized during metabolism of several amino acids. And example of such amino acids are glycine, serine, histidine and tryptophan. So these are the four amino acids. During the metabolism of this four amino acid, there is a synthesis of one carbon group. Example of one carbon groups formed during the metabolism are methyl, that is CH3 group, methylene, that is CH2, methenyl, that is CH, formyl, that is CHO, formimino, that is CH double bond NH. So all these groups are synthesized during the metabolism of glycine, serine, tryptophan and histidine. And all this group except methyl will be carried or transferred by tetrahydrofolate. This tetrahydrofolate, it is the active form of folic acid. So this is the structure of tetrahydrofolate. This N5 and N10 are the sites for the binding of methenyl group. So methenyl group will get attached to this N5 and N10. So this is the structure of tetrahydrofolate. Now let's see how this tetrahydrofolate synthesized. This tetrahydrofolate is synthesized from folic acid with the help of folate reductase enzyme. So this is how this tetrahydrofolate, which is the active form of folic acid, gets synthesized. So one carbon groups which are carried by the tetrahydrofolate are attached either to the nitrogen N5 or N10 or to the both, that is N5 and N10. The different one carbon derivatives of tetrahydrofolate are N5 methyl tetrahydrofolate, N5 N10 methylene tetrahydrofolate, N5 N10 methenyl tetrahydrofolate, N5 formyl tetrahydrofolate, N5 formimino tetrahydrofolate. So these are the different one carbon derivatives of tetrahydrofolate. This all the different derivatives of tetrahydrofolate are interconvertible. They can interconvert with each other. So now let's see how this one carbon group are going to synthesized and how they are going to utilized for the synthesis of various important biomolecules. So the formyl tetrahydrofolate, which is synthesized from formate and tryptophan, is utilized for the synthesis of C2 of the purine ring and for the synthesis of formyl methionyl RNA. Fine. Formimino tetrahydrofolate, which is synthesized from the histidine amino acid, is going to help in the synthesis of C8 of the purine ring. Hydroxymethyl tetrahydrofolate, which is synthesized from the choline, serine and glycine amino acid, it gets converted to the methylene tetrahydrofolate and it is going to synthesize glycine, serine and deoxythymidylic acid from the deoxy UMP. So this is how this methylene tetrahydrofolate is important for the synthesis of glycine, serine and DTMP, that is deoxy TMP. This methylene tetrahydrofolate, with the help of reductase enzyme, and it is an irreversible reaction, it gets converted to the methyl tetrahydrofolate. And this methyl tetrahydrofolate is important for the various transmethylation reaction, synthesis of choline from the serine, synthesis of creatine and the synthesis of epinephrine. Fine. All the one carbon groups carried by the tetrahydrofolate are channeled At the end, it gets channeled into the methyl tetrahydrofolate, and this methyl group gets accepted by the homocysteine, and this homocysteine gets converted to the methionine. This is the picture showing the generation of one carbon group and synthesis of one carbon group. Various substances which are synthesized from the one carbon group are C2 of the purine, formal methionyl RNA, then C8 of the purine ring, then synthesis of glycine, serine, synthesis of deoxy TMP, synthesis of creatine and epinephrine. This is the summary of one carbon metabolism. As we have seen, all the one carbon group which are carried by the tetrahydrofolate, it gets channeled and it gets channeled to the methyl tetrahydrofolate. And this methyl group from the methyl tetrahydrofolate is accepted by vitamin B12, and this vitamin B12 gets converted to the methyl cobalamin. So this is the one of the very few reaction which is occurring in the body. Over here, this vitamin B12 acts as a coenzyme. So if there is any deficiency of folic acid, then there will be also the deficiency of this methyl cobalamin. After accepting the methyl group, this methyl cobalamin, this methyl group will be donated to the homocysteine, and this homocysteine will be converted to the methionine, and methionine gets converted to the S-adenosylmethionine will donate the methyl group to the methyl acceptor, and this methyl acceptor will be converted to the methylated product. So this is the overall summary of one carbon metabolism. This is the one of the very few reaction occurring in the body where vitamin B12 act as a coenzyme. Importance of one carbon group metabolism. One carbon groups at the different levels of oxidation are transferred and made available by way of the tetrahydrofolate and vitamin B12 coenzymes for use in a wide variety of vital anabolic processes. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from my YouTube channel. Thank you.